Hello everyone, how are you? Today I am going to introduce you a band sealing machine, which is actually a 4-in-1 machine. It has many functions as compared to the traditional band sealers. This is not the traditional one, this is something special. It can do normal bag sealing as well as it can print on them. Now you will say nothing special in that. You must have seen band sealer with the printer, but what if I tell you that this machine can also do the vacuum bag sealing. It can vacuumize the product and then seal it. What if I tell you that it can remove the air, it can suck the air from inside of the bag and then fill the inert gas or like nitrogen gas inside the bag and then seal it with the printing. Isn't it interesting? Please see the video till the end to know how all this feature works. Here we go. Before we start, please subscribe our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Let's see its operation one by one. On the right side of the machine, there is an MCB for the power supply. We can make it on. And then let's learn about the control panel. This is the emergency switch. You need to make it on to operate the machine. If it's pressed, machine will not operate. Then there is the main power. We will switch on the power supply. As soon as you switch on the power supply, the conveyor will start running. The next one is for the heater. Once you switch on the heater, the temperature controller will be switched on and it will rise to the set temperature, which is 180 we have set, and it's currently at 150 because we just switched off the machine before the video. The next one is the fan. We need to make it on as soon as we keep the switch heater button on. The next one is the printing feature. If you want to use the printing feature, which is here, I will show that later on. The next button, this one is for the vacuum suction. If you can see this thumbnail logo, this is for the suction. So if you keep it on, the machine will start sucking from this nozzle. And this one is for the gas flushing. When you attach a gas source or any source, it can fill the gas after the vacuum is done. So we'll test it this also. And this timer, this will only operate when you print on the when you switch on the printing. So it will show how many bag this will act as a counter for the printer. This is the delay button for the printing. Means once the bag is cinched, where to locate the print on the bag. So after the bag gets cinched, after how much delay it should print, this is the delay setting. This is the temperature for the printing. We can keep it on the medium. And this one is the conveyor speed of this belt. We can make it fast or slow or keep it on the medium. Initially I will just operate the machine without printing, without vacuum, without nitrogen sealing. So I will just feed the bag and see the normal band sealing. Okay, now. So we have not did anything other than the sealing. Now let's do the vacuum. So I will make the gas flushing off and I will do the vacuum to see how it works. For doing vacuum, you need to insert this nozzle into the bag and press the foot switch and then feed the bag. this is the difference. This bag has been vacuumized and then got sealed. Now let's see, let's understand how this is working. When I switch on the vacuum function and when I press the foot switch, as soon as I press the foot switch, it started sucking the air from here. Right now it's not sucking anything. But if I press the foot switch, it started sucking. You can see it's sucking anything. So as soon as I put the paper, it keep on sucking. The suction has started. And once the nozzle have been moved by the bag, the suction stops. Now this is not sucking. So when we press the foot switch, the suction starts, and when the nozzle moves sideways, the suction stops. But if I add the gas flushing function, then what happened? Let's see. I press the foot switch, the suction started, and when I move the nozzle sideways, vacuum will stop, but it will start throwing the air. Currently we have not attached the nitrogen cylinder, but we are using the compressed air from a air compressor, and we have attached the pipe here. This is showing the air pressure or the gas pressure. So how much gas you want to flush, it depends what pressure you set. This is the flow rate, of course. The more flow rate you will increase, and more time it will get, it will increase, it will fill more air in the bag. So let's see next bag with the vacuum plus nitrogen flushing. We are activating the vacuum function by pressing the foot switch and first inserting the nozzle into the pouch for the vacuum. Once the vacuum is done, we are trying to feed it straight. With practice, you can make sure the pouch get fed straight and you get the perfect sealing. Let's again do one bag with only vacuum, and I will show you the inner operation by opening this cover. Perfect vacuum. Thing is not moving a little bit. Let's understand more about the printing function. As I told, I will explain later. This is the delay, but how to use this delay? The more I will rotate this knob towards clockwise, the earlier it will start printing. Now it's completely towards clockwise at the end. So you see how the sensor, as soon as it senses the pouch, the printing wheel start moving. It's very fast now. Means the printing will happen immediately. Once the pouch comes, printing wheel will start immediately to print it. So you will get printing earlier. But suppose if I move it towards anti-clockwise, I'm moving too much to show you the difference actually. Now if we see, the printing don't start immediately. Once the sensor turns green, after certain time the wheel starts. You can see. It don't start immediately. So when you feeding the bag, if you need printing immediately, keep it towards clockwise. When you want printing after some time, keep it anti-clockwise. So suppose I need the printing immediately, I am keeping it somewhere here, and now feeding the bag to see where I get the print. It's feeding the bag. The sensor light turns green and I got the print at very start position. But suppose now I want the print somewhere in between, at the middle of the bag. So I am rotating it towards anti-clockwise again. And now let's try the same bag again. Okay. So you can adjust the printing position like this. And the printing is very sharp. You can see. This got retorted because we fed the same bag again and it got heated. You can change the printing later by opening these two bolts and removing the block. And this is the ink roller, hot ink roller, which once it starts, the printing gets start fading, means the ink got finished, you need to replace that roller. So you have seen how this single machine can do all four tasks: sealing, vacuum sealing, gas flushing, as well as printing. I hope you like the video. If you have any question, any queries, please send us an WhatsApp inquiry or email inquiry. Both WhatsApp number and email is given in the video description below. I hope you like this video. Thank you very much, and please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for more videos like this. Thank you.